Hello everyone, I Jhalak Patel, Assistant Professor at LG Institute of Engineering and Technology in the Department of Electronics and Communication, welcoming you to my channel of Wireless Communication. Today we are going to discuss about Unit 2, the Cellular Concept, with topic Basics of Cellular System, Channel Assignment Technique and Handoff. Let's start with Cellular System. First of all, why cellular concept is important? Because in the older days, a single high power transmitter with antenna is generally used. Because of the limitation of single high power transmitter, cellular concept is introduced. Because single high power transmitter introduced system congestion, which produced spectral congestion, and user capacity was a major concern. Here, the demand for mobile services introduced the cellular concept to utilize better system resources like this. Here you can see that the whole area is divided into number of cells, like the individual tower for rural area as well as for individual towers for urban area. The cellular system allows each cell phone to be manufactured with the same set of channels. So this is how the cellular concept allows each cell phone to be manufactured with the same set of channels so that any mobile can be used anywhere in the service region. The next is, why in a cellular system hexagonal geometry is generally preferred over different shapes? First of all, we consider circle. Why circle is not preferred choice for cellular concept? Because in circular pattern, adjacent circles can have gaps in between or can create overlapping region like this. Here you can see that adjacent spacing will be present in case of circle. If we take the second consideration, it is area. Area of hexagon is more compared to rectangle or square. Here you can take the example of rectangle. If we consider the area of rectangle, then it is A into B, and if we consider the area of square, then it is A square, where A and B is the side of rectangle or square. That's why we choose the hexagon geometry. There is also another criteria for hexagon geometry, which is radiation pattern, because hexagon geometry is closely approximates the circular radiation pattern in an omnidirectional base station antenna. That's why it is easy and manageable analysis in cellular system. That's why we prefer hexagon geometry into consideration. Next is frequency reuse concept. Why frequency reuse is generally taken? Basically, the frequency reuse is the design method of selecting and allocating channel groups for cellular base station with a system, and it is called as frequency reuse or frequency planning. Here you can see that the cell, which is denoted by A, use same set of frequency. That's why it uses same set of frequency and it is marked as A. Because of same set of frequency use, here the same antenna is used in all the three cells, which introduce that like that. Here in this case, it reduces the height of transmitting antenna, like the first figure shows here is without frequency reuse concept, and the second figure denotes with frequency reuse concept. Likewise, we can say that with frequency reuse concept, the height of transmitting antenna is reduced. So basically, it denotes to the cluster size, like capacity of cellular system. It is denoted by cluster size. It is given by n equal to I square plus ij plus j square. Capacity of cellular system is given by cluster replicated into number of channels. Here the cluster size is equal to n is equal to I square plus ij plus j square, where I and j are integer numbers. Basically, the co-channel concept has a relationship with distance to frequency reuse ratio, like this. Distance to frequency reuse ratio is given by d by r, and it is equal to under root 3 n, means it is under root 3 times cluster size. So this is how one can calculate the capacity of cellular system. Next is channel assignment technique. Here we can say that the radio spectrum needs to be efficiently used, and for achieving the we need of frequency reuse method can be used. But to achieve the main objective to increase the channel capacity and to minimize the interference, channel assignment technique is used. Basically, it has different three purposes: to efficient utilization of channel, to increase capacity, and to minimize the interference level. There are two different types of channel assignment technique. The first one is fixed channel assignment, and the second one is dynamic channel assignment. Let's start with fixed channel assignment technique. What are the purpose of fixed channel assignment? So in fixed channel assignment, there is predetermined set of voice channel. Because of that, frequency of use for candidate cell, and if the cell are used, then call is blocked. In such situation, user can also use cell borrowing technique. Here in this method, cell is allowed to borrow channels from an adjacent cell if all its channels are occupied. This method is called as borrowing strategies. So all these points are related with fixed channel assignment. For dynamic channel assignment, we consider the reduces probability of borrowing, means there is no permanent allocation of channel. Every time a call request is done and base station requests a channel from MSC, means mobile switching center, it provides traffic distribution properly compared to fixed channel assignment. Due to this, it accurately occupies each channel to particular cell, and this will give proper strength to radio signal of that particular channel. It increases, but the limitation of this dynamic channel assignment technique is it increases the load on MSC, but it provides the advantages on increased channel utilization and reduced the probability of block calls. So this is two types of channel assignment techniques which are used in cellular concept. The next one is handoff strategies. As we discussed in our earlier lecture series that about what is handoff. So basically, handoff is when one particular user crosses the boundary between two base stations. Here you can see that here these two regions have different base station antenna. Here first base station antenna, and here the second base station antenna. Here you can see that the signal strength is indicated over here with red color. So when user crosses the boundary and enter into another cell, handoff occurs. Here you can also see that the signal strength is increases when as user moves towards the base station, and the signal strength reduces as user moves away from base station. Once again, you can see over here, signal strength is increased as user is nearer to base station. As user moves away from base station, its signal strength reduces. So this is how handoff phase occurs. Now we will see about different handoff strategies one by one. First handoff strategies are proper versus improper handoff. So first of all, we consider the first figure for handoff strategy, which is improper handoff technique. In case of improper handoff technique, in the first figure, this, you can see that the delta is too small and insufficient time to complete handoff before call is lost. Because of these, weak signal conditions will be taken into consideration and handoff will not occur. While this is improper handoff case, where delta value is either too small or either too large. Basically, delta value is difference between received handoff signal power minus received minimum usable signal power. In the second case, you can see in the second number of figure that this case is for proper handoff condition. In case of proper handoff condition, the handoff is taken place because of RSSI level, means radio signal indicator, is at optimum level. That's why handoff occurs at level at point B, like this. This is the second case, which is of proper handoff. Now the second handoff strategy is inter-system handoff. During a call in progress, if mobile moves from one cellular system to different cellular system, then it is called inter-system handoff. The next one is dwell time. As the mobile moves from serving base station, there will be a drop in signal level. So dwell time is basically the time period for which call is maintained in cellular region. It also depends on different factors like propagation or interference between cells. The next is MAHO, means MAHO, mobile assisted handoff. Mobile assisted handoff is basically taken place at faster rate. In mobile assisted handoff, each mobile station measures the received power from surrounding base station and gives data to reporting base station. This gives the current base station's location when handoff is initiated. The next one is priority based handoff. It also has two types. First one is guard channel concept. In guard channel concept, it is similar to fixed channel assignment type. Here, a part of total available channels in a cell is reserved for handoff request from ongoing calls. While in case of queuing, it decreases the probability of termination of call because of lack of available channels, and it is possible because of finite time interval between received signal level. The next technique is umbrella cell concept. Practically, in a cellular system, there are several problems, like high speed vehicle can pass through different cells quickly and quickly handoff can occur. In this case, umbrella cell concept is used. In this case, the whole area is divided into high velocity traffic area and low velocity traffic area. Means you can say that it is divided into macro cell and micro cell. Here in figure you can see that small micro cells for low traffic area and the larger umbrella cell for high traffic area. It provides larger coverage to high speed user. It also provides the advantage of minimization of handoff for high speed users. It also provides additional micro cell channels to other users, and It also reduces the burden on mobile switching center. Okay, so these are the different strategies for handoff. If you have any queries, you can ask me on my email ID. Thank you for watching.